Hey guys, Alenteca here, and we are back with more Homesick. Took me a second, sorry about that. Where we left off, we came to the gym, we beat the gym, and now we're on to the next bit. It's very weird playing a game with no background. All I gotta say is it's very weird playing a game with no background music. There we go. Okay. Hello, piano. Okay, that was fun. What is this? I can't read sheet music. Hope they don't expect me to read sheet music, because I can't do that. I don't know how to do that. Are you a door? You're the other doors. Itchy nose. Hey, look, more cipher stuffs. Okay, this still doesn't help me because I don't know the cipher. I really hope the game doesn't expect me to try to decode it. Because I'm not good at such things. Alright, well, let's keep looking around. We saw the piano. Very cool, very cool. It's over here. We have a breaker box with more code. Still not going to help me. I keep thinking I'm hearing whispering as well. That's on already. Hello. That's really bright, game. Oh, is this like a thing? Well, that probably says home. Then the two lines. Homo, something, 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 something. Backwards C? Is it S? Alright. Home, C home. Slash. Alright, guys. We are back, and I believe I have deciphered most of the letters. There are a couple blocks I cannot find. But I found most of them. So let's go ahead and try to read one of these magical things that we've never been able to read before. Dear Mr. Riggins, this letter is in response to your inquiry regarding the slope of protection afforded to whistleblowers and whether you would qualify as a whistleblower under the law of this jurisdiction. From what you have. Thing that should be conveyed to me. I believe you'd be protected under the letter of the law. However, given the recent political climate, There has been several cases of individuals who deserve protection, but the government found reasons to deny them protection for political reasons. Okay. From our preliminary investigations conducted by our investigative team, it appears that there are indeed violations of several environmental laws occurring on an ongoing basis, putting the entire region at risk. My advice is for you to go public with your information, and myself and my colleagues are ready to defend you to the fullest extent provided under the law. However, I do warn you that it will be a difficult battle with many risks. Sincerely, Lewis. So, I will be right back one more time after I fix those glaring errors, so BRB again. Alright guys, we're back, and I just thought it was funny that that said link. But yeah, either way, I think we've got it all deciphered. I think all the letters are back in the right spots. We're going to go take one more quick peek at that letter, and then we should be able to proceed onwards. If I get motivated, I might go back and reread all of the things that we couldn't read before, because that's the story. Yes, that's much better. Still can't find the C or the P, but I can forge forward with that. Yeah, we're good there. Alright, let's continue and find out what we're doing. Apparently, there was bad stuff going on. There were a couple dogs. Deforestation. Gas masks. I'm reaching the point where I can no longer turn a blind eye to what is going on. I'm not sure what to do about it, but I just can't ignore it any longer, pretending everything is okay. What are my ethical obligations to my supervisors? To the people working under me? To the community? To myself? I've worked so hard to get where I am. It has been a long road to get to become the assistant manager of operations in my department. I'm sure many would kill for my job because I get paid more and have more opportunities for future promotions. Does that all mean I should just do what my supervisors want me to do and not say anything about all the problems that I see? I just heard from a neighbor that those filing cabinets in the large community room down the hall used to be in my department. I guess the guy used to live in my apartment unit, who was the manager before I took over the position, was transferred to a different district really quickly. The move was so quick that he didn't take all his belongings with him, and a bunch of filing cabinets were left. The janitor moved them down the hall, and I don't think he even realized what was still in there. There are slides and newspaper articles in there that make me think the previous manager was concerned about some of the same awful things I'm seeing now that I have as a job. I guess he never spoke up about them, but I think I will. Page 100. I finally found an attorney to talk with. I'm hoping you have some advice about what I should do. I think there are definitely some laws being broken. I started to have doubts today. If I do speak out about what I'm seeing, will I lose my job? Where will I go? Would it even make a difference? Interesting. Now we have story. Secrets to Being a Powerful Leader by Bulford Duke. I still might have the Y in the wrong spot, but I'll live with that. Dang it, I can handle it. Alright, lights are on, lights are on, lights are on. Make sure all the lights are on, because dark is bad. Still can't get in here, huh? Oh, I can. Wait a minute. Am I? I am. This is my apartment. I can go back through and read the story, which is exactly what I'm going to do. Peaceful Drift, a collection of poems about sleep and renewal by Fritz Moyer. That's cool. I can read things, guys. We're going to read things real quick. That's going to be the rest of this video. Dear Tosh, thank you so much for your letter. It was so nice to have a piece of you here with me as I try to get comfortable in my new place. I've been babysitting a little boy that lives on my floor. He reminds me so much of you as a little kid. We have been playing with blocks with letters on them, just like the ones you used to have. My trip was amazing. The months went by very fast. It took me a long time to find the village. It was in an even more remote location than I had expected. They really are creating something new, a refuge from this crazy world. They're generating their own power with solar panels and wind turbines, and they're growing all their own food. There are fruits, vegetables, herbs, and grains growing all over the place. And every spare inch of soil, even on rooftops and on the sides of dwellings. The most amazing thing was how hopeful everyone was. It felt so safe, and for the first time since we were kids, I felt hopeful for a better future. I wish I could have stayed there longer, but I hope that the money I earn from this new job will help us buy land so that we can start a new village together. Love always, your sister, Samin. Cool, we have story. That's what this game was. That's what this game was missing. All the sense and understanding. I barely slept at all last night. I was tossing and turning for hours. I couldn't stop thinking about my new job. It's so awful here. There is so much destruction and pollution. The air is thick with smog and toxic dust. People say we're helping to provide energy, but I think there has to be a better way. I just want to earn enough money so that I can leave this place. One nice thing did happen today. For lunch, I sat with one of the other workers that happens to live on my floor. He was such a nice guy. He told me about his family and how he hopes that this place isn't too dangerous for his child. Like me, he hopes to earn enough money at this job to be able to leave and to move someplace better. I told him about my insomnia, how I can't sleep because I'm overcome with worries about how bad things are. He was so understanding and nice to talk with. I wish he and his family lived next door to me instead of my current neighbor, the bachelor. He's so loud all the time with his parties and dates, making it even harder for me to fall asleep. I started babysitting my co-worker's son. He's such a fun little kid. Spending time with him really lifts my spirits. He's doing so well starting to learn to read. I think his other favorite thing to do is play hide and seek. The other day, he was playing a game of hide and seek with his parents, and he hid in my apartment. And I wasn't even home from work yet. His parents went looking for him and found him in here. Aww. That's really cool. I like story. Story time. All the story. Leave the hall lights on. Management. Okay. Management wants the hall lights on. Alright, so this is the bachelor's pad. Lessons My Grandfather Taught Me by Brent. What do we got going on here? We are separated now, as she said, but I still have years and memories of her. Memories of good times past. I still dream of her every night, but where the dreams end and the memories begin, sinks to the abyss of everyday obscurity. Now only a few things still linger as a reminder that some part of it was real. The hardest part is letting go, letting the memories blend together into my dreams. The saddest part is losing the details as the memories become only stories. It's like you losing years of myself. Aww. That's sad. Guys, this game's gonna make me sad. She's out there somewhere. Is she thinking of me like I'm still thinking of her? I only wish I could understand why I wasn't enough. Where did things go so wrong? It was such a gradual decay. I can't pinpoint when things changed. I know that we were happy together. I loved you. I thought you loved me. I don't know how to feel good again when the person who knew me the most, more than anyone else, more than I know myself, can no longer stand to be with me. Aw, this game is gonna make me sad. God damn it. I didn't want to be sad. Stupid game. The history of Sob. I don't care about Sob. Make sure all the lights are on. All the lights have to be on. This video is going to be a bit long because I have story to read. It's story time, guys. You guys like it when I tell you stories. The moon and the stars. AA. This must be the kids' apartment. Dear Gertrude, thank you for your letter telling us the good news that our application has been received. We are very excited to become parents. We are very much looking forward to when there is a child ready for us. Sincerely, the Willows. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Willow, we've received your completed application to adopt a child, and we have received confirmation from the inspector that you passed your interview and background checks. Congratulations! There is a waiting list of other applicants, and your application will be added to the queue. The average wait time is 6 to 9 months. On behalf of the agency, I thank you for wanting to open up your home to care for a child in need. Please contact my office if you have any questions. Regards, Gertrude, social worker. Okay. That's it. Alright, let's keep on walking and reading. Walking and reading. This video might be a bit long, but we're gonna walk and read. Childhood development and psychology. Oh, they were trying to actually be decent parents. Or a parent, either one. To our dearest son, we received your recent letter telling us the news that you and your wife plan on adopting a child. While we are happy that you want to have a family, we don't think it's a good idea to adopt. You won't know this child's background or genetics. Our family has superior genes, and we would be sad that the child won't look like you. There are so many stories of adopted children that end up abandoning their adopted parents. Don't do this. Love your parents. Well, fuck you guys. You superior gene bullshit. To my love, happy anniversary. These past few years together have been a dream come true. I'm so excited to get to have a family with you. I know things have been hard on our job with our jobs here, but I know together we can do anything, and we can even create a loving home in this hard place. So many children have been orphaned because of the dangerous conditions and violence in this region, and I know we can provide a loving home so that at least one of these children will no longer be alone in this scary world. I know some of our family members don't support our decision, but we have to do what is in our hearts. There may be stories of adoption that result in heartbreak, but there are many more stories filled with smiles and happiness. I love you, and I am so excited about this next exciting chapter of our lives. Love truly. Love truly. Yours truly, Elliot Winslow. Fuck this game. Making me all sad and shit. Turn the light on. Alright. And this is... Is there any more notes in this first entry area that we went to? Notes. Alright guys, that is all for this video. I'm going to resume going back through the rooms in the next video and reading more stories. So hopefully you guys are enjoying story time with Online Tech Guy, and I will catch you in the next video. Later!